process of additive machining is really taking apart, slicing it down into fine layers, and printing the layer by layer to create the solid object.
There is no limitation of the geometry you can build if you have the proper design. So because you're building layer by layer, you can have a very complex design, and you will be able to do it.
Subtractive manufacturing is the previous paradigm for making a material. You start with a block of metal, and you chop it, and you shave it, and you lathe it, and you smooth it round, and you throw away all this extra material, and there you have your final part. Additive manufacturing will build the part up from the raw material, ideally without any excess and without any waste.
We can reduce the size of the part. We can make it more cost effective. Sometimes in some application, there are parts which you remove 90% of the material to get the shape you want. So you can now reduce or save materials, reduce scrap, making things faster, you reduce time to market.
To make a part, say for example, I need to make a car wheel, for example. You all go to buy fancy aluminum wheels for your car. To make that wheel, I need to design it, then I need to make a mold into which liquid metal is going to be poured in. By making that mold can take from 6 months to 1 year. That means when I design the wheel, I don't get to see it physically until about a year later. With additive, I can draw a sketch, and the following morning, I have it on my table.
It's really about specialized and personalized things. In the music business, now people can buy download products, right, or songs, right down, and they can get those even though there may be only 100 of those made. It used to be all you could buy was the big hits, right, because that's what people could distribute, and they had the big record companies. So this is what's going to change over here is now we can have parts made just for you. Now, they could be for fun, right, or it could be for serious things like medical prosthetics. You really would like to have your prosthetic to be personalized to you. And so this is what it's going to enable, is the fact that we can now make parts on demand for people. Advanced manufacturing is new ways of making things. Additive manufacturing is one way of doing that. And specifically it's for, I would say, macroscopic parts. I mean, things that are not you can almost call semiconductor manufacturing additive manufacturing, but it's very small stuff, right? So this is things you can see, feel, and use in your hands. And additive manufacturing is just a subset of this advanced manufacturing.
It's been a very invigorating session. And the reason being, we are making parts with additive, but we don't understand how it works. What this workshop has done is to say, bring about experts within the US that are looking at how the process actually works. And that's giving us even better insight on to say, how do we need to actually make this thing even produce better parts?
The breadth of topics discussed at this workshop was very, very constructive. We talked about basic materials science, materials physics, materials chemistry. We talked about how to extract from that basic material to processes developed in additive manufacturing. And those processes are actually pushing the boundaries of what we can do scientifically. That also pushes the boundaries of what we can do computationally. So we need to bring together fundamental science with very high performance computing. And then we discuss how to make that a reality and make products and interact with industry and interact with basically the man in the street. Ultimately, that's the end goal. So it basically took it from basic science all the way to consumer products, which is quite a broad suite of things.
The amount of work presented is incredible. The fundamental result of the modeling that I have seen is really very, very useful. I was amazed with the amount of progress and the progress on the additive manufacturing modeling, it really makes me feel that collaboration is very important. Honestly, what we call private and public collaboration is important, because you don't need to repeat this effort. It's available. Build on it.